Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. Today I'm talking about finding a least common multiple and finding an equivalent fraction. Least common multiple, abbreviated as LCM, means the least or the smallest number you can find that would divide evenly by the two numbers in question. We don't just say smallest because small just talks about size, not really about quantity, so it's a little deceptive. We could write something really teeny tiny and say that's a small number, but it might be that we wrote 1 million really teeny tiny, right? So least is a better number. That's why we use that in this definition. So find the LCM for the following pairs of numbers. What we want to find is the least number that 7 and 11 would both divide evenly into. And we can see that 7 and 11 are both prime numbers. They have nothing in common. Sometimes, to find the LCM, you just multiply the two numbers together. So if I say 7 times 11 is 77, then the LCM is 77. 7 goes evenly into 77, and 11 divides evenly into 77 as well. So that's it. Now I have the numbers 5 and 15. Well, 5 and 15 do have something in common. In other words, I don't just want to multiply these together, because 15 would divide into itself evenly, and 5 would go into 15 evenly. Sometimes the LCM that you're looking for is actually one of the numbers in question. So in this case, the LCM is just 15. That is the very least number that we can find that would divide evenly by 15 and 5. So those are the easy cases, and if you have those when you're using this to add unlike fractions in a little while, that'll be nice. But what about the ones that aren't quite as obvious? So I did a 3 number one here. Maybe I should have done another 2 number one to get you warmed up, but I'm going to go ahead and jump into this. No, I'm going to go back and do this. What if I wanted to find the least common denominator for 18 and 28? Well, 18 and 28 don't have, one doesn't go into the other, but they're not totally different like these because they have a common factor of 2. So here's how I would do that. I would take the 18 and the 28, and I would write an upside down division symbol. And then I would say what number goes into both of these two numbers, and that is 2. So I'd write that out to the side. 2 goes into 18 9 times, so I'm dividing. 2 goes into 28 14 times. Then I would say, is there anything that goes into both 9 and 14? And if there was, I'd keep working, but there's not. Nothing that goes into those except 1, but 1 never helps us. So then I look at what I have in my L. That is for LCM, and I multiply those together. My LCM here is going to be 2 times 9 times 14. And if I multiply that, 2 times 9 times 14, I get 252. And that means that 252 is the least number I could get that 18 and 28 would both go into. Look at 252 divided by 18. That comes out to be 14. And 252 divided by, what was the other number, 28. That comes out to be 9. So 252 is divisible by 18 and 28 evenly. That makes it the LCM. Okay, that's a 2-digit one. Let's look at a 3-digit one. This method that I'm using is just one method. There are other methods in finding the LCM. You can always go onto YouTube and Google LCM and see somebody else doing it a different way if you don't like this way. This is the, I don't know what this is called. I call it upside division, down division method. When I'm working with 3 numbers, I want to first say, is there anything that goes into all 3 of these numbers? And there is not. So then I say, well, is there anything that goes into any 2 of these numbers? And maybe you'll see, well, 5 goes into 10 and 35. So I'm going to divide by 5. 14 is not part of this. I'm just going to bring it down unchanged. 5 goes into 10 twice, and 5 goes into 35 7 times. Now, just like back here, I want to say, oh, is there anything that goes into any 2 of these? Well, I can see that there is. 7 goes into 7 and to 14, so I'm going to do another layer, and I'm going to say 7, but 2 has nothing to do with this, so I'm just going to bring that down. 7 goes into 14 twice, and 7 goes into 7 1 time. Well, now we can see, oh, we still have a 2 that goes into both of these. So I'm going to divide by 2. 2 goes into itself once, and 1 wasn't any part of that, so it just came down. Notice that I came all the way down to 1. That doesn't always happen. It doesn't happen that often, but it happened here. My LCM is everything in the L. Now, multiplying by 1 doesn't change anything, so I don't really need to multiply by all those 1s, but just for our purposes, I'm going to write it out. 5 times 7 times 2 times 1 times 1 times 1. And that equals 70. So then you say, well, is that true? Does 10 go into 70? Yes, 7 times. Does 14 go into 70? 70 divided by 14 is exactly 5. And what about 70 divided by 35? That's 2. So this is my LCM. That's the least number that I can find that has all of these numbers as factors. In other words, they all divide evenly into 70. Okay, let's try that with 2 more. I'm doing the bigger, harder numbers because the smaller ones are easier to do. One other method that people have that they talk about is just to take the largest number in the group, in this case 100, and count by 100s until you find a number that the other two numbers go into. But you can see how long that would take you, 100, 200, 300, 400, 500. You'd be up to 9100 before you found that number, right? So in some ways, that method is a little bit slow. So I like this method better. So let's go through it again. I'm going to write my 3 numbers. And I want to ask myself, is there anything that goes into all 3 of these numbers? And there's not. So then I say, well, is there anything that goes into 2? And I can see that 10 goes into 2 of these numbers. I'm not changing 91 at this point, so I'm just bringing that straight down. 10 goes into 77 times, and 10 goes into 100 10 times. Okay, so then I say, well, is there anything that goes into any of these numbers? Now, you might not be able to look at 91 and 7 and say, does 7 go into 91? That's when you want to use your calculator. 7 into 91 is exactly 13. So I can take 7 into these two numbers. You should have a calculator at your side when you're doing math. I think it's nice to not spend a lot of time struggling on those kind of concepts. 7 goes into 91 13 times. We're not dealing with 10 here. We'll just bring that down. 7 goes into 7 1 time. Now, is there anything that goes into 10 and 1 and 13 besides 1? And the answer is no. So now I'm going to multiply everything in my L. And I would get my LCM is equal to 10 times 7 times 13 times 1 times 10. And it turns out that 9100 is the number I was looking for, it looks like. But we can multiply that out to see 10 times 7 times 13 times 1 times 10. Timesing by 1 doesn't change anything. My answer is 9100. 9100 is the first number that these three would all go into. Okay, moving on. What about this one? One method would be to start by 96 and start counting by 96 until you found something that everything would go into. Another method is the method that we just saw. So if I did this correctly, we'll see what happens here. So is there anything that goes into all 3 of these numbers? Now maybe you would say, oh, 4 goes, which would be awesome. Maybe you would say 8 goes. Maybe you would say 2 goes. The thing is here is that it's okay as long as you find something. So let's say that you just said, well, I know they're all even, so 2 goes into those. Well, that's going to give you 24 and 8, and half of 96 is 48. So maybe here you'd say, oh, but wait a second. 8 goes into all 3 of those. Maybe you would say 2 again. It doesn't matter as long as you keep doing correct divisions all the way. 24 divided by 8 is 3. 8 divided by 8 is 1. And 48 divided by 8 is 6. And now you say, is there anything that goes into all 3 of these? Well, 1 is out. But I can take 3. 3 goes into itself once. Here, this one came down, it wasn't part of it, and 6 divided by 3 is 2. So now, I didn't get down to all 1s like I did up here, but I got down to saying there's nothing else I can do. And now I'm going to multiply everything in the L to get my LCM. And that equals 2 times 8 times 3 times 1 times 1 times 2 which is 16 times 3 times 2, 96. Oh, so one of our numbers, 96, was the LCM, which we found it this way. Finally, on this video, I wanted to talk about building a fraction into an equivalent fraction. If I have 3/5 and I want to rewrite it with a denominator of 20, I would multiply 4 times 5 to get 20, so I'm going to multiply 3 times 4, and that would give me 12 20ths. These are equivalent fractions with different denominators. If I have 4, I can think of that as 4 over 1. And if I want to get a denominator of 7, I'm going to multiply by 7. So I have to do the same thing on the top. 4 times 7 is 28. And over here, I have 9 sevenths, and I want to get to 49. I'm going to multiply by 7, and 9 times 7 is 63. So I can always build a fraction by multiplying both the numerator and the denominator by the same number. All right, have a fantastic day.